From Arlington Stadium in Arlington, Texas, WGN is proud to present Chicago White Sox baseball. Tonight is the White Sox versus Nolan Ryan and the Texas Rangers. And hi, everybody, and welcome to Arlington, Texas. I'm Ken Harrelson along with Tom Pachorek as the Sox get ready to take on Texas in the second of this four-game set after taking the opener last night in one of the most thrilling finishes to a ball game, Wimpy, we have ever seen. We talked about it after the game. What a play Joey Cora made on Mario Diaz trying to score the tying run in the bottom of the 13th.
Well, Joey Cora did an excellent job of backing up, and that was the key to the whole play, Hawk. He was there. He was in great position to make this play. And as you can see, Mario Diaz is an easy out. Good tag there by Matt Marulla. Super throw from a running position by Joey Cora.
Well, obviously, Nolan Ryan on the mound tonight. Ryan, in the last two times he has faced the Sox at Arlington Stadium, Wimpy, he's been, what you could say, dominating.
Yeah, he's been pretty good, Hawk. 19 innings, he struck out 31, giving up only four hits and no runs. Nolan Ryan can no-hit you on any given night, but the Sox have got the momentum on their side right now, winning 6 out of 7 on this current road trip. But like you said, and the Rangers are losing 11 out of 12.
All right, Alex Fernandez will tee it up against Nolan Ryan, and we'll be back to give you the rest of the starting lineups right after this.
White Sox baseball on Channel 9. The White Sox are brought to you by Miller High Life. Buy that man a Miller. The best comes shining through. The good guys at Dodge, where it's Advantage Dodge. True Value. Got a tough job to do? You can do it with True Value Hardware Stores. Southwest Airlines, offering everyday low fares and convenient flights to both Detroit Metro and Detroit City airports. Phillips 66 high-quality super clean gasolines, keeping your car's fuel injectors and intake valves clean for smooth driving performance. Mark's Root Beer, the one with the bite. The Chicago Tribune, get in the game, pick up a trip. And your local Toyota dealers, I love what you do for me, Toyota.
We're back at Arlington Stadium in Arlington, Texas. Game two of the four-game series between the Sox and the Texas Rangers. Sox winning last night. And the Sox are now 6-1 on this current road trip. And let's take a look at the starting lineups. First for the White Sox, given by manager Jeff Torborg. The Sox now 28-26, 5.5 games out of first place in the American League West. Tim Raines will lead off. He'll play left field. Batting second at third base, Robin Ventura. Pick Frank Thomas will DH. He'll hit third again. Cleanup man is first baseman Danny Pasqua. Matt Marulo replaces Carlton Fisk, and he'll catch batting fifth. He's followed by right fielder Sammy Sosa. Lance Johnson is the center fielder batting seventh, hitting eighth at second base, Joey Cora, and the ninth place hitter at shortstop, Ozzie Guillen. Defensively for Texas, Juan Gonzalez plays left field, Gary Pettis in center, Ruben Sierra is the right fielder. Steve Buschel plays third base. Jeff Houston, a defensive standout last night, is the shortstop. Julio Franco is at second, and Rafael Palmeiro is the first baseman. The battery tonight of the Express, Nolan Ryan, and his battery mate tonight will be Gino Petralli. Nolan Ryan on the season is 3-4 with a 3.45 earned run average in 9 games started. He has one complete game, that being the no-hitter against the Toronto Blue Jays earlier. An incredible hits per innings pitched ratio, only 37 given up in 60 innings. 23 runs on the year. He's walked just 22 while striking out 76. That's another great ratio. The American League is batting just 177 against Nolan Ryan. And last year he allowed no runs on 4 hits in 19 innings and 2 starts at home against the Sox last year. It was another story at Comiskey Park. The Sox beat up on him pretty good at Old Comiskey, but this is Arlington Stadium where Nolan Ryan certainly likes to pitch in his home state. He is 305 and 276 in his career. Against the White Sox, he has won 20 ball games, losing 15 in his career with a 3.29 earned run average. So Nolan Ryan, he's got the great fastball, overpowering most of the time in the low to middle 90s. Still has an excellent curveball. He will throw a changeup, sometimes turn over his fastball as well. The umpires tonight, Ted Hendry is at home plate, John Hirschbeck at first base, Dave Phillips is at second, and at third, Terry Cooney. Here's a look at Arlington Stadium. I'll tell you, another huge crowd on hand. They've been drawing very well here. Of course, Nolan Ryan generally packs them in on the night that he pitches. So the Sox going after victory number 7 on this current home, a road trip that is, and they'll lead off with the very hot hitting Tim Raines. So to bring you all the action, here's the Hawkster.
All right, Wimpy, thank you very much. And once again, good evening, everyone, and welcome to Chicago White Sox baseball. It'll be Raines, Ventura, and Big Frank Thomas here in the first inning to face the 44-year-old right-hander, 6'2", 212 pounds, out of Alvin, Texas. There you see the numbers on Tim, that average right now at the 300 mark. And as Webby mentioned, last 21 ball games, he has been warm. He is hitting 417. Of course, these two have faced each other many times. Nolan was with Houston. Raines last evening, 2-for-5. Oh, what a ball game last evening, if you missed it. The play by Joey Cora was nothing short of just sensational. In fact, it took Joey 5 or 10 minutes to come down. He came right out of it. There's a shot. Watch out, Barry. Got the hit out on that Ryan fastball, and the count 0-2. There's Joey. He was taking his teammates' hands off, giving them those high fives. Also, yeah. Sammy Ellis came up to give him one and said that Joey almost knocked him down, hit him right in the chest. Outfield swung around just a little bit to the left, bunched. Bouchel well off the line at third. It's a little low, Ted Hendry says, and the count 1-2. 330 down each line here at Arlington Stadium, 380 in the power alleys, 400 straightaway center field. Ryan, 5,384 Ks in his career. That's good.
That's a bunch. Oh, boy.
Curveball. Hendry started to come up with that right arm. Ryan wanted that one. Didn't get it.
And then Ted realized that it was a bit low.
Watch Ted Hendry's right shoulder here.
He may have locked him too with that pitch. Excellent downer right there. We understand that Nolan in his last couple starts has had trouble with his curveball, throwing it over the plate.
Well, if he has trouble with his curveball, he's going to get beat. That's off the plate, and the count goes full. In fact, this is June 11th, the anniversary of the no-hitter he threw last year against Oakland. Also, Johnny Vandermeer threw one on this date. There's a shot, base hit right into center field. So Timmy picks it right up again. And there's that big Mo.
Mo is something. I'll tell you, Timmy got the fastball down out over the plate, and he nailed it for another base hit. Ryan against Oakland, Vandermeer, and Wicker, whoever he is, versus the New York Giants.
How do you throw, Wimpy?
He wasn't too tough. A little sinker slider. He got me out anytime he wanted, but you were really tough on him, I understand.
Wicker with the Cubs as Robin Ventura steps in. Robin hitting at 272. Pretty good lead by Raines. Ryan does not have a good move to first base. Ventura 1-for-4 last evening. Timmy 18 stolen bases in 22 attempts. Bouchel at the cut of the grass at third. Ryan will hold a ball on Raines. There goes Tim, a big leg kick. There's a throw by Petrolli, not in time. 19 stolen bases, thank you.
Well, the book on Nolan Ryan is that you can't steal on him because of that high leg kick. Now, Timmy Raines, certainly one of the best in the business, especially in stealing base percentages. As you can see, studying Nolan, he picked him up real quick. The first pitch he ever saw him throw, well, he's seen him throw in the American League, that is, because he has certainly had a lot of experience against Nolan in the National League. So he didn't waste any time. He knew him. He knew what he was going to do, and he got a great jump.
Robin's got to try to get him over, but the count moves to 0-2. Last night's ball game off the tough right-hander out of Georgia Tech, Kevin Brown. Raines double. Robin then sacrificed him over to third base, and he scored on the bouncer by Thomas. Right here, a little different story with the no ball, two strike count. Fastball off the plate and the count 1-2. There you see 11 for 14. I mentioned he does not have a good move and he does have the big leg kick. Pitch high off the plate. Two balls, two strikes. Usually Nolan Ryan, it takes him a couple of innings. In reality, even though he goes down to the bullpen, he warms up. It takes him a couple innings as a rule to get loose out there and to get that rhythm, that tempo that a pitcher needs, and especially a power pitcher.
Yeah, most great pitchers, you got to get them early in the ball game. Once they get their rhythm and get established out there, they're awfully tough.
Robin pops it up. Bouchel. So there's one gone. Baines and Franco having a little chat right there. Boy, Timmy, just lull him into a little false sense of security. Get a good lead and go ahead and steal third. Here's Big Frank. Drew the collar last night, but he had a couple of walks. Big Frank leading the American League in base on balls with 51, hitting at 303, 8 homers, and he's knocked in 42. Outfield, for the most part, straight up. Franco jockeying in behind Reigns as the pitch over and count nothing and one.
Well, look at this, 25 first inning runs and 30 starts last season, so that will verify what we were just talking about, Hawk. The takes him a couple innings to get his act together.
Fastball inside. Ryan giving it a little shrug right there. Feels like Hendry's squeezing him in the count 1-1. As we mentioned, Nolan with those 5,384 strikeouts. He had 300 or more strikeouts 6 times in his career. He's had 200 or more 14 times. 7 no-hitters. 12 one-hitters. 19 two-hitters. 33 hitters. Watch out. So Thomas is drilled with a good fastball.
Take a look at it. Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide on this one. See, Frank gets it up on that left hip. And he just had nowhere to go on that one. That one just riding in on him. Here's Pasqua with runners at first and second and one out.
Well, in our Sox pregame show with Sid Garcia back in Chicago, I was talking with Sid about Nolan Ryan. It's tough for a right-handed hitter. Only two right-handed hitters in the lineup tonight, Thomas and Sosa. It's tough for a right-hander because Nolan, he will throw at you. There's no doubt about that. And in the past, in his career, when he was younger, he was wild as he gets a curveball over to Pasqua. But make no mistake about it, the seemingly country squire, Nolan Ryan, will definitely throw at you. That curveball low in the count, 1-1. Recall last year, first time little Craig Graybeck came up. Graybeck and Ozzie went back to back off Ryan at Comiskey Park. Craig walked up here, first inning, he just drilled it. A pitch inside. And the count, 2-1.
He's scuffling right now.
Good. Like I said, Danny, just throw him a fastball and take him out of here. Put 3 on the board in a hurry. Oh, pull a string on him. Good pitch by Ryan on a 2-1 count. That straight change. Boy, those strong left-handed hitters, that is just as devastating as his fastball.
Well, you talked so much last night about controlling the speed of the bat of the hitter. Boy, with Nolan Ryan, throwing 90 plus and then getting down in that 70 mile an hour range, that's a big difference.
Comes back inside and the count goes full. Well, it is. You got to get that hitter out over that front hip a little bit. That's what Ramon Garcia did so well last evening. Control the speed of the, there's that 21-year-old rookie right-hander who's been out there three times and just been impressive more and more each time. He controlled the speed of the Ranger hitters last night. This Ranger club is a very good offensive team.
Oh, sure. They got as good a lineup as anybody in baseball, top to bottom.
There's a shot. Wow. As Raines was off. So the count hangs at 3-2. I don't think Thomas caught the sign.
No.
In fact, missed the sign.
Unless Timmy was just going on his own, because, well, you got to think that Tim Raines is certainly going to be in motion here, 3-2 with one out.
You mentioned, though, you got Ryan. He's, you got him right now. He's struggling a little bit. Of course, anybody else but Tim Raines. You don't want to get thrown out third with a left-handed hitter. Yeah, one out when he's struggling.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That catcher's looking right at the guy, and he's only got 90 feet to throw. So Timmy's got to make sure he gets a good jump. On the other hand, Jeff Houston, his job, along with Julio Franco, is to hold him a little bit closer, which would open up another hitting zone for Danny Pasqua to shoot for.
Houston right in behind Raines now as they do not go. And Danny hangs tough.
This is a good at-bat for Pasqua right here.
As we mentioned, Danny 0 for 5 last night, but he hit a couple right on the money. Hit a bullet to Bouchel at third, hit a line drive in a left center field. Gonzalez made a nice catch on. Runners do not go. Pull the string on him. There it is again. Good change by Ryan.
Knowing Ryan throws a circle change, you can see the grip in his hand right there. And that ball just kind of tails away from Danny, as you can see, down and away. See Danny opening up early, really was not anticipating that on 3-2. Fortunately, Raines was not in motion on that particular count. So Marullo will hit with two down.
Matt hitting at 327. Three homers, 12 RBIs. Takes a strike, a fastball. That was not 227. That has been something, this youngster. 1-for-2 last night coming in for Carlton Fisk, who, once again, if you did not see it, was hit on a thumb. Lays off the curveball, takes it low. Right above the right thumb, towards the back of the hand, a foul tip got him, and after the game last night, it was ugly. Carlton said during the game, as soon as it happened, a big knot jumped up there. 1-1 pitch to Matthew. High down the right field line. Sierra has room. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. So Matt just missed it. Nothing across. There was a hit, no errors. Two men left. And after a half inning of play, it's the Sox nothing, and Texas coming up.
No score, bottom of the first inning here at Arlington. The Sox wasting a single by Tim Raines and a hit batsman. They could not score against Nolan Ryan. And this is the way the Rangers will line up against Alex Fernandez. Leading off, DHing Brian Downing. Batting second in center field, Gary Pettis. Rafael Palmeiro, the former Cub, will hit third. He'll play first base. Cleanup man is right fielder switch hitter Ruben Sierra. Julio Franco will hit fifth. He'll play second base. Franco is followed by Juan Gonzalez, the left fielder, in the lineup. The bottom third of the lineup batting seventh, catching Gino Petralli. The eighth place hitter is third baseman Steve Bouchel. And batting ninth at shortstop, last night's defensive star, Jeff Houston. Rangers are 26-25 on the year, six games back. Defensively, the Sox have Raines, Johnson, and Sosa in the outfield, Ventura, Guillen, Cora, and Pasqua around the horn, and the battery tonight of Alex Fernandez and Matt Marullo. Here's a look at Alex, 2-5 on the year, 5.71 earned run average in 11 games started. Hasn't completed any of those. He has pitched very well as of late, giving up 64 hits and almost 65 innings work. 41 earned runs. He's walked 38. That's a problem, Mary, but he's striking out almost one an inning, 57. American League batting 260. And his last start Thursday against the innings, he worked six strong innings, gave up six hits.
Brian Downing takes a strike on the outside corner. 40-year-old veteran. Brian 0 for 4 last evening, hitting at 317. He is 0 for his last 8 and 4 for his last 37. Outfield shaded to the left. Pitch back out of play and the count quickly 0-2. Rangers a home mark of 12 and 11. Sox a road mark of 16 and 14. As we mentioned earlier, the Rangers won 14 in a row earlier. Since that time, they've lost 8 straight and 11 of 12. Up high, 1-2 the count. Just gets a piece of it. So Downing. What a year he's having. 40 years old, didn't have a job, Wimpy. Rangers took him on down there to spring training. Well, it's been history since that time. He's also the best start really he ever had in his whole career.
Yeah. Well, it just goes to show he's out there having fun, really not worrying about anything.
There's a little duck snort, a broken bat single in the right field.
Now Alex made a pretty good pitch here with the slider, and Downing just got a piece of it off the end of the bat. Brian pulling off of that pitch, but he stands so close to the plate, he gives himself a chance to handle that pitch outside. There's Bobby Valentine, the Rangers manager, talking with Ruben Sierra, his cleanup man. So the Rangers have their leadoff man on, and Gary Pettis will hit. Now you're probably wondering why Brian Downing is a leadoff hitter. Why not Gary Pettis? Well, Downing is third in the American League in on-base percentage at .429. Here's Pettis. They might play little ball here, try and get him in scoring position by bunting.
Well, you can do that a lot easier when you got Nolan Ryan on the hill as Pettis squares the bunt, takes a strike. Rangers with that .278 team average leading the American League over Minnesota, who's at .274. Sox are in sixth place with a .259 mark. So Pettis, 1 for 4 last evening. He's 4 for his last 26. Switch hitting, speedy center fielder is Marullo. Makes a nice play right there. And the count evens at 1. Now feels short, swung around to the left. Sox last year had a slim 7-6 season series edge over the Rangers, but in 7 games here at Arlington, they were only 3-4. Short lead by Downing. Watch out, ball gets away, but Pasqua just knocks it down enough with his glove to control.
There you see Danny just taking a swipe at this ball. Unfortunately for the Sox, it doesn't get too far away. Danny jumps on the ball, and Downing doesn't have a time to advance right there.
See Toby Hara, he was getting himself in position to get out of the way. Now, when we talked about it in Cleveland, also in the Oakland game, Alex having some problems throwing over to first base.
Yeah. Yeah, he has. He certainly hasn't made too many throws over there on the mark. Maybe not making that full turn or getting himself in proper position to throw over there.
Ball and 2 strikes to Pettis. It appears that he's just trying to make the throw too quickly. But Alex, just 21 years old. Of course, the Sox, as they did in Oakland, running a couple of 21-year-old right-handers out there back-to-back. And talking to Jeff Torborg about it, Jeff said, yeah, they're going to stagger him up later on because the stuff of Garcia and Fernandez are so similar. He doesn't want to give the, in this case, the Rangers, an opportunity to see those two kind of guys back to back, as he does not want Greg Hibbard to follow Charlie Huff.
Yeah, well, that's the truth. You really got to kind of get those guys mixed up, but.
Yeah, Jeffrey.
He'll think of something.
Yeah, they're going to stagger him up. That's high in the left field. One gone. And we saw some outfielders last night on both teams having trouble picking it up in the first couple of innings. It's a tough time of the evening.
Excuse me, Hunt. We're out of ballparks. I like that. We also saw Timmy Raines have trouble with the light standard here in left field. Ball not quite the line drive, just above a line drive, and not quite a fly ball can fall in there. You just don't pick it up because of the lights.
Here's one of the best pure hitters in all of baseball. Just 26 years old, Rafael. You see the numbers on him. 1-for-5 last evening, hit a couple of bullets. Sammy Sosa was busy in right field as Palmeiro and especially Gino Petralli, they were just playing line drive pepper with him. There's the strike and the count, nothing and one. Right now, let's pause for station identification.
This is WGN-TV Chicago, America's number one sports station.
Along with Tom Pejorek, this is Ken Harrelson from Arlington Stadium in Arlington, Texas. Second of this four-game set. No score, bottom of the first inning. Change off the plate. 1-1 the count. 31,000 plus last evening, and there is seemingly many more than that tonight with Nolan Ryan on the hill. Rangers have been drawing well, averaging 28,414. Watch out, Alex.
Yeah, I think there's a lot of clubs that are going to draw very well in this American League West, or the American League in general, because of the closeness of the races. Mark, I think there's at least six teams right now that could be classified as certainly candidates to win this division, and that's certainly going to help at the turnstiles.
Turnstiles?
Yeah, you know where they come in.
This should be 6-4-3, rack 'em up. Double play, and that'll do it for the Rangers here in the first. Nothing across the hit. After one, no score. Turnstiles. No score, top of the second inning. And a reminder that Friday, June 14th at 7:05, the Sox begin their series against the Kansas City Royals and George Brett. Don't miss that game, where the first 20,000 adults will receive a can wrap courtesy of Miller Lite. So get there early. Wimpy's going to be around. And, of course, they don't have many wraps big enough to go around his can.
Make mine an extra large, please.
Here's Sammy. It'll be Sosa, Johnson, and Coral. No runs on one hit for the Sox. No runs on one hit for the Rangers. Sammy 0-for-5 last evening. Sammy scuffling. Thing about Sosa, though, even when he's scuffling with the bat, he means so much to the total overall picture of the Sox, playing that great defensive right field that he does.
Well, he never lets up from 1 second, whether it be at the plate or in the field, when he isn't going good at the plate. He's just flying off the ball right now, trying to become a dead pull hitter. And when he's doing that, he's just not a good hitter. He hit one ball hard last night, and that was a hard shot to the second baseman. And that was the best swing he has taken in quite a while, because when Sammy is going up the middle in the opposite field, he is an excellent hitter, capable of hitting in that 280 to 300 range. When he's trying to pull, forget it.
He's had a tough time against Nolan Ryan as Petralli moves to the outside. And the count 2-2. Who's your pick to click tonight, Wimpy?
Oh,
you're
boy.
Down four, you know.
Okay, I'll take Reigns.
Okay. I got Matt. I'll take Matt.
Ooh. He had a good pass at that ball in the first inning.
Yes, he did. He just missed.
Yeah. Well, he just gets, Matt Marulla just gets better as a hitter every time he walks up there, it appears. From spring training on, he's just getting better and better.
2-2 pitch to Sosa. Second strikeout for Ryan.
I know Sammy wants to perform so well in front of his ex-teammates, but as you can see, he opens up way early. You see that belt buckle as he is striding, and with that, he drops his back shoulders. It's tough for him to make contact, especially when you're talking about 90 mile an hour plus fastball from Nolan Ryan.
Here's Lance, a couple of base hits and five trips last evening. Corners in close, fastball high. Well, who would you guess that throughout Nolan Ryan's career has struck out the most against him?
Active player?
No, he's not active anymore.
That's a good question.
There's a strike. Well, it's a tough question. I don't expect you to know that. Claudel Washington.
Claudel,
yeah, 39 strikeouts. Freddie Patek, second with 31. That's a whole bunch of K's there. George Orta, 30 times. That's hit into center field. Gary Pettis, he's there. That win will bring it right back over to him. And there's two gone.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. If I struck out 39 times against one guy, I'd make sure I wasn't in the lineup. I'd fake something that I didn't have to play against that guy.
Now, let me see here where it says Wimpy. Okay. Strike.
I just think just once or twice. I probably didn't even make the book.
Two times. Two punch outs. Joey, look at this. That's trouble. That's down the right field line as Cora. That's going to be for extra bases.
Three.
As Sierra gets to it. Now Cora, now he turns it on. He slowed up, but he will get into third with a triple. For Joey, that's his first extra base hit in a Sox uniform.
Well, the Ranger defense is certainly playing Joey Cora to hit the opposite way against the fastball of Ryan. He got a fastball down and in here, and you see Ruben Sierra nowhere in the area as it bounces once, twice, kind of rolls to the fence. And Joey was going to stop at second base, but then he regrouped and made sure that he went onward. And that's very important to get to third base because you can score on a wild pitch even though there are two outs. Something crazy happens. So he is at third with that stand-up triple. And Ozzy with an opportunity to drive him home.
Yeah, Joey was just looking over Terry Bevington all the way there. He had that play. He should have known it.
Oh, sure.
So Ozzy, who has been swinging the bat a lot better, even though he drew the collar last night. And if you recall, I'll tell you, one of the most unusual things you'll ever see last year at Old Comiskey Park, that big yard, when Ozzy and Graybeck and Ozzy went back to back of Nolan Ryan in two pitches. Who'd have thunk it?
Who would have thunk? By the way, did you get to the H's in that book to see how many times Harrelson went down?
No, I only spaced him in spring training.
Oh, okay.
You know, he was with the Mets. That's popped up left field. Jeff Houston now makes a call, the catch, and that'll retire to the side. So nothing across. There was a two-out triple by Cora, and after an inning and a half, no score. That's the story, bottom of the second inning. And a reminder, USA Today All-Star Balloting continues. Just pick up a ballot today and vote for your favorite White Sox players.
And there you see it, no score in the bottom of the second inning. And between innings, we're talking about tough pitching staffs. And of course, Nolan Ryan was part of that great pitching staff at New York, but he wasn't the guy that you really feared to face the most.
Oh, no, not at all. In fact, you know, that they had Seaver. They had Nolan, they had Matlack, they had Gentry, they had Kuzman. And the guy that I always hated hell the most by far was Kuzman.
Yeah.
I mean, he would bust you inside
knock
fastball
you out your butt
in spring training. When I was with the Red Sox, we used to play the Mets an awful lot each spring, seven or eight times, I don't know, maybe more. But we were always getting those guys. And, of course, it was good for you in spring training because it got you ready for the season.
Yeah.
As Ruben Sierra steps in, Ruben hitting at 330, 8 homers, 38 RBIs. Ruben 0 for 5 last evening. In fact, he's been in something of a little bit of a funk. He's 3 for his last 23. But that won't last long.
No.
This young man, just outstanding. That's deep to right center. Sammy has the beat. Now Lance calling him off, makes a catch. He just missed it.
Yeah, he just did. just by a hair.
No, Wimpy, but getting back to that staff there, I'll tell you, that Kuzman had one of the greatest, had to have one of the greatest arms in the history of baseball.
Yeah, he was so resilient. He pitched in the 60s effectively, the 70s, and the 80s, too. Of course, he was part of our staff in 1983 when we won the divisional championship, and he was throwing right around 90 miles an hour then. Then, of course, he went to Philadelphia where he finished up.
Here's Julio Franco hitting at 307, five homers, 25 RBIs. Takes a strike on the outside corner. Well, you know, you look at that staff when you talk about great arms. They had Tom Seaver, Kuzman, Nolan Ryan.
Right.
Isn't that amazing?
Oh, boy.
Three of the greatest in the history of the game.
And they certainly won with pitching. And whatever defense these guys would, whatever plays the pitchers would make those guys play, make. There's some bad hands out there by the officer in center field. Yeah, but Kuzer was really amazing. I hope he's watching the game in Minnesota someplace. Give our best to him. One of the most fun guys I ever played with.
Frank Howard, Jerry Kuzman, those guys, they just don't come any better than those guys.
No, they're the best.
Greg Luzinski.
Yeah. Bulzer's probably in front of the TV right now.
he's got at least one beer in front of him. 0-1 to count. Takes it high. Franco, 297, lifetime major league hitter. And a final from the National League this afternoon. Giants came back to beat the Cubs in 10. Seventh win in the last 11 games for San Francisco. Watch some of that game. That was a tough loss for the Cubs.
Yeah, it really was, especially since the Giants didn't have any of their regulars in the game. Even Roger Craig, they quoted him as saying that this looks like a B game at in Scottsdale about 10 o'clock in the morning, the players that he had available, but they did the job for him.
Two balls and a strike, one out here in the second. With other scores, Toronto leading Cleveland 1-0. Top of the seventh inning at Cleveland Stadium. That's on the outside corner. Franco doesn't like that one either. And the count 2-2. Kansas City shutting out Baltimore 7-0. Bottom of the sixth at Memorial Stadium. Minnesota trying to make it 10 in a row. Lead the Yankees 1-0. Top of the fifth at the Hubert H. Humphrey Metrodome.
Musical streaks is what we're having in the league right now. Minnesota is certainly the hot team in baseball.
Stay out there, Matthew. Attaboy, a slider.
Oh,
he's
boy.
Gone. He'll grab some bench.
Now, Franco didn't like that at bat at all. He took a couple of close pitches and then he went for one about 8 inches outside, probably feeling that he had to protect outside. Look at it. Slider misses. Geez, that's almost a foot outside. Julio with that big heavy bat. Once it starts, I'll tell you, it's tough to contain that thing.
You know, he wanted to turn around and say something, but he's a much more of a mature veteran now than he used to be when he was at Cleveland.
Sure.
Here's a good looking young player right here. 21 years old, Juan Gonzalez, hitting 314, seven homers, 38 RBIs. He has as many RBIs as games played. Drew the collar last night. There's a slow curveball from Alex. Ramon Garcia did a number of one.
Oh, he tied him up in knots up there.
Yeah, he might
he
have.
He had no chance.
Of course, if you have not seen Ramon Garcia pitch, you will. Back out of play. He's a good one. And for all the guys out there, there's Garcia. He's got that good face, too. 6'2", 200 pounds out of Guanare, Venezuela. He will throw that change up to the right-handed hitters at any time. And for the most part, he knows exactly what he wants to do out there. Got great mound presence.
Yeah, I was talking to Toby Hera, the first base coach for the Rangers, before tonight's ball game, and he said when he saw Garcia, a second there's a slider outside, when he saw Garcia warming up and throwing the first couple of pitches, he said, we're going to murder this guy. He's got no chance against our lineup. Meanwhile, 8 innings later, nothing but goose eggs. Toby, that's...
Can you imagine him throwing that 3-2 change to Hera? That's the way he is.
Yeah.
He screwed himself right in the ground.
He said he was very impressed, though.
Oh, there's that good slow curveball. He'll grab some bench, so two strikeouts. For Alex here in the second, 1-2-3 inning after two, zip, zip.
A participating advertiser in White Sox baseball are the good guys at Dodge, where it's Advantage Dodge.
There it is, top of the third inning. And reminder, you can enter the Southwest Airlines White Sox Home Run Derby, and you just might win a trip from Chicago to Kansas City to see the Sox and the Royals, plus a super sweet party for 20 of your friends at the new Comiskey Park. Now, this is all part of Southwest Airlines' 20th anniversary celebration. Find out how you can win later in tonight's ballgame. It'll be the top of the order for the Sox here in the third. Raines, Ventura, and then Thomas. Tim led it off with a solid shot to center. Stole second. Number 19 for him. Outfield straight up. Corners in close. Takes a fastball strike. That's the last seven games. Coming in hitting .417 the last 21. Fastball. Oh boy. So the count quickly 0-2.
Bobby Valentine was so impressed with Raines last night and his performance. He ignited the team. He says he might, by the end of the year, he might be the best offensive player in the American League. He thinks he's going to hit at least 330, 340.
Outside, a ball and two strikes. Well, we talked about it earlier, Wimpy, outside of the power factor, as you look at the very young, still 40-year-old skipper of the Rangers, Bobby Valentine. Outside of the power factor, he has so much more positive luggage than Ricky Henderson, not even close.
Yeah, I agree.
A curveball low and inside, and a count 2-2. I mean, he has the good attitude. He is great in the clubhouse. Works very, very hard in the community. He's got more tiger in his tank.
Yeah. His teammates just love him.
Yeah.
He's a part of everything. He's a part of the team, not a one-man show.
Pops this pitch back. Get out of here. Petralli.
It will. Really? Tough to foul out here, Hawk. There's very little foul ground. Plus, when you do hit one high in the air, the wind usually pushes it one way or the other. And that direction is always out of play. So you see very few pop-ups caught in foul territory.
Two balls, two strikes.
Usually it'll save you a couple points on your batting average by the time the end of the season comes around.
Yes, he did. And Timmy knew it. Good pitch by Ryan. Third strikeout for Nolan.
He just dots the outside corner right here. You see, the fastball had a little bit of tail to it, but it was certainly over the plate at the knees. And that all-important leadoff hitter off base for Nolan Ryan. I'm sure he's glad to get Raines out of there, because every time Timmy gets on tonight, I'm sure he's going to take off on Noli.
Here's Robin. Popped up to Bouchel his first trip. Takes a strike on the inside corner. You know, it's fun to look at this list here. They've got Ryan's all-time strikeouts. We mentioned Claudel leads it with 39 punch-outs. Rod Carew, 29. Andre Dawson, 26. Pudge, 24. That's shot. That's fair ball. Yes, right down into the corner. As Robin will turn first, move into second with two-bagger number 7 on the season.
Well, we saw Robin Ventura do this exact same thing against Roger Clemens at Fenway Park. Get the head of the bat out and drive the ball hard down the right field line. Take another look. Petralli wanted the pitch away. He got it in. And look how quick the head of the bat gets through the zone. No chance for Palmeiro. So Robin, stand-up double, and a runner in scoring position once again for Frank Thomas.
Big Frank was drilled. His first time up, Nolan hit him with a good fastball. So with that hit by pitch, Big Frank has reached base in 54 of the 55 games that the Sox have played. Oh, good hack. Pops it up high, towering pop up right side. Franco.
Wow, that coming down, it finally does. That pitch was just a bit out of Frank's zone. Not about a letter high fastball right there. Frank
he had a good hack at it.
Yeah, he did. He just couldn't get on top of it. So two down for Pasqua. Danny was a strikeout victim his first time up. Good changeup. Ryan struck him out on.
Threw him two good changeups in that sequence.
And Danny saw quite a few pitches in that at bat, so that'll set up this one a little bit better for him.
The only thing is, when you see that 3-2 change,
yeah.
That adds another 4 or 5 inches on Ryan's fastball. As uh-oh. There he comes with it, checks it up.
Well, don't go up there looking for Ryan's changeup now.
No.
That would not be a very positive move.
Some of the other hitters on Ryan's all-time strikeout list with a 15 or more. Reggie Jackson, 22. Greg Nettles, 22. Rico Petrocelli, I wouldn't have believed that. Yeah. Petrocelli with 21. And Rico, of course, has been out for a long time.
Yeah, that's true. Well, Reggie's a guy that I should have thought of immediately.
There's a curveball. Danny doesn't like that one. And a count 0-2.
He's not a very good job of catching the curveball by Petrali. As you can see, he turns his glove over like that. He didn't get it underneath him. He just kind of slapped at it. I'm surprised Tedrick gave him the call.
Got him, backdoored him with a curveball. So strikeout number 4, and as we were talking about earlier, you don't want Ryan to hit that stride, that rhythm out there. Nothing across after 2.5, no score. No score, bottom of the 3rd inning. And a reminder, the Cleveland Indians come to Comiskey Park for a 2-game series Tuesday and Wednesday, June 18th and 19th. Great seats are still available. So just visit your nearest Ticketmaster outlet or call 312-831-1SOX. Alex Fernandez giving up one hit, has 2 strikeouts. It'll be the lower third of the Texas order. Petrali, Bouchel, and Houston. So here's Petrali. He was 0 for 5 last evening, but that is very misleading. He hung out 4 ropes.
Yeah, he hit the ball very hard. A couple line shots right at Sammy Sosa, who was guarding the line on him.
Outfield bunched, but they're swung well around to the right. Ventura, even with a bag, off the line at third. Breaking pitch high. And we were checking this list out on Ryan strikeouts. 16 for George Brett, but really that's not many at all.
Yeah.
Nolan Ryan has beaten Kansas City more than any other team in his career. He's 23-12 lifetime, so you're talking about 35 decisions. 16 strikeouts is not many. I wouldn't have thought he'd have got George that much either.
Yeah.
One and one the count. Oh, yeah, nice. Changing speeds, throwing strikes, that's what it's all about.
Location not that good right there, but the off-speedness of that pitch. Upstairs with the fastball, just misses.
2-2 the count.
It's like a change.
Fastball. He's got a 2-seamer and a 4-seamer. So the count goes full. There he got him with a fastball right down the middle. He'll grab some bench. So 3 consecutive strikeouts for Alex.
It looked like right here that Gino Petrali is guessing breaking ball, something off speed. Fastball, maybe a little bit of a tail to it. And that's right where Petrali likes the ball. Gino likes that ball on the inner half of the plate so he can pull, but just couldn't pull the trigger there.
Steve Bouchel steps in off to his best start ever. And he's been in something of a slump lately, 6 for his last 38. Bouchel leading this club in homers with 9, has 23 RBIs, and what a third baseman he is. He's outstanding.
Yeah, there was talk in the paper today of bringing up this one of the kids from the minor leagues.
Dean Palmer.
Dean Palmer, 21 home runs now at Oklahoma City, moving Bouchel to shortstop. And Bobby Valentine feeling that that isn't their biggest need right now is some more punch. They need some pitching help.
1-1 pitch to Bouchel. Fastball.
I saw Palmer the last couple of years, Hawk, being called up at the end of the year. You've never seen a ball jump off the bat like it does Palmer. It's amazing. Young talent, I think he's 21 years old right now. So they've got a good nucleus of youngsters here, plus a good couple of good kids coming up. A Rodriguez, 19-year-old catcher, fine prospect as well.
Quick breaking pitch low and away. 2-2. So he's got a live bat, huh?
Yeah. He makes contact, it jumps. And obviously he is now developing as a good hitter in the minor leagues.
That's in the center field, as Alex could not make a play on it. Alex usually a very, very fine fielding pitcher. So the second hit for our Texas.
Well, this ball must have had some topspin because I thought Ozzy was going to get to it. But Ozzy playing up the middle as Bouchel will pull on the ground. There you see he got a good jump on it, but had a topspin going through the hole. And Alex, as you said, usually very reliable, just couldn't get to it.
Now, he didn't have himself in good position. He had to jump from like almost a straight leg position.
Yeah, Alex usually squares up pretty good.
Here's the shortstop, Jeff Houston, hitting at 194, 0-for-3 last evening. He is 3-for-his-last-33, but he threw some leather last night. He made 4 plays. 2 of them were just sensational.
Yeah, he did everything last night. He went to his right, backhanding from the hole, showed a very strong arm. He came in strong, and he went to his left very well.
Short lead by Bouchel. No runs on 3 hits for the Sox. No runs, 2 hits for Texas. Second of this 4-game set. Sox took that one last night in 13 innings, 3-2. Very thrilling finish.
That game last night had a little bit of everything, didn't it? Not a whole lot of hitting.
Pitching.
Yeah, had some great pitching and some great defense, but some bad defense.
Yeah. Back the error by Sierra. His first, Rubens' first of the season, cost the Rangers the ball game in the top of the 13th. Sox have an error, led to an unearned run. There's Ruben. So the count 2-0 to Houston. You know, Houston drew a walk last night, as we talked about. The two guys you do not want to walk in this lineup are Houston and Pettis.
That's right. Well, you know, if you want to consider anybody out on that ball club, those are the two guys that you have to really make sure that you bear down, just like the other hitters in the lineup. Can't afford to lose them, especially both of them had good speed and capable of running.
He walks him. First walk issued by Alex. Well, if you're in a clubhouse meeting and you come up to Houston, what are you going to say? You're going to say, go right at him, don't walk him.
Yeah.
Make him swing the bat. You come up to Pettis, what are you going to say? You're going to say, go right at him, don't walk him. Make him swing the bat. Of course, when you get some of these other guys, you say, wait a minute now. This guy, you can't do this and you can't do that. This guy's hitting 313. Before he walks out of there, he's hitting 390.
Yeah.
Before you walk out of the meeting. I've seen some managers turn 240 hitters into 330 hitters before that meeting was over. You can't make this pitch. You can't do this. You can't do that. Here's Brian Downing. He had a little duck snort, a little blooper into right center field his first trip, broke his bat. So Bouchel at second and Houston at first, one out. Breaking ball misses.
It's an interesting alignment on Brian Downing. Raines is way over there in left center field, and Lance is playing him straight away. Sammy pretty much straight away in right field, too. But You know, Brian Downing has been known as a pull hitter for much of his career. See that open stance? He likes to hook the ball.
Fastball high, so Alex getting himself in the jackpot right here.
Of course, Downing is one of those guys in situations like this where the team needs a base hit. He will try and hit the ball up the middle in the opposite way. That makes him doubly tough.
One reason that Ramon Garcia last evening against Texas, or against any club, not just against Texas, but Ramon last night, he was 0-1, 0-2, 1-2 on virtually every hitter.
Yeah.
This is the kind of club here, you get behind them, the way they can swing the bats. The Grim Reaper's just around the corner. There's a striker on the outside corner. 2-1 to count. Jackson National League scores for you. Cincinnati leading Montreal 6-1. That's in the eighth inning. Mets leading Atlanta 2-1. Top of the ninth at Shea. There's a strike in the count, 2-2. Pittsburgh leading the Dodgers 1-0, top of the second at Three Rivers. Later on, St. Louis takes on the Padres out in San Diego. Philadelphia at Houston, no score, top of the fifth at the Astrodome. As we showed you earlier, the Giants beat the Cubs this afternoon at Wrigley Field in 10 innings, 8-6.
The Yankees trying to end that Minnesota winning streak with a 2-1 lead in the seventh inning at the Metrodome. That's a big game.
Yeah,
Yankees.
They were trailing 1-0.
Yeah, and the Yankees are only 3.5 games back in the American League East, believe it or not. That's a good comeback they've made behind the Stumper. Did you ever figure out why they call him Stump?
Yeah, I finally figured it out. But I'm not going to say. Kansas City still shutting out Baltimore 7-0 in the seventh. And bottom of the eighth inning at Cleveland, Toronto 1, Tribe zip. Well, Gene Michael's done a good job over there staying with those young kids. That has been the key to that turnaround. Misses with the curveball on 2-2. So with one out, Bouchelle at second, Houston at first. We'll see what Bobby Valentine wants to do.
Well, Bobby, when I played for him, it was automatic.
Yeah.
If you went on 3-2 or 3-1, it was automatic run, regardless of the outs, whether no outs, one out, certainly with two outs, you're going to be going. But he had a don't run sign in certain situations, but I'm sure that's not on here. Downing a good contact man.
So a big pitch right here for Alex. Yeah. He and Matt are going to take a long time hooking up on it.
I don't like that when Alex takes a long time between pitches.
There go the runners. He strikes him out, and they're going to throw him out. Yes! Second double play turn by the Sox, and that'll do it for the Rangers. Nothing across. It was a hit. No errors. One man left. And after three, no score.
Here's a huge play that ended the third inning for the White Sox. You can see Brian Downing swings at a bad breaking ball in the dirt. Easy double play right there, and that would have been bases loaded and one out. So Fernandez pitches out of a jam.
Here's Matt Marullo. Takes it down low. No score, top of the fourth inning. No runs, three hits, no errors for the Sox. No runs, two hits, and no errors for Texas. Matt just missed one in the first inning. A couple of guys on. Got that one in on him. A little looper into right field. Ruben Sierra is there, and there's one gone. He's the all-time starters. Rolling down a tie for third place with Phil Niekro, 716 starts.
That's some Don Sutton, number two on the list. Boy, Sutton was resilient too. You know, he just never missed any starts. He went out there. I think Don just had one 20 game, 20 win season, but he was so consistent all those other years.
Sammy takes a strike on the outside corner. Sammy, a strikeout victim his first trip. Ryan has four. Alex has three. In that 8-6 Giant win over the Cubs, Downs a winner, Smith a loser. Dave Rigetti picked up his sixth save, Rags, with number six. Matt Williams, homer number 8. Luis Salazar. Luis, a couple. His numbers 5 and 6. And Hector Villanueva, number 5. And his account quickly 0-2 to Sosa. No balls, 2 strikes, 1 out. Outside. Cleveland has scored a run in the bottom of the 8th inning, still hitting. They have tied up the Blue Jays at 1.
Yeah, Cleveland's having so many problems scoring runs this year, and that big ballpark not helping them, although it is helping their pitchers, and they are staying close.
They hit the first home run this month last
yeah,
night.
Yeah, isn't that something?
That curveball, Bouchel. Boy, he's got some good hands. So two out, and that'll bring up Lance Johnson. Lance flied to his counterpart, Gary Pettis. Boy, crowd has just continued to file in here, and hope you can't see a vacant seat. Boy, there's some fannies and some seats out there.
There certainly are. Tuesday night sellout. Well, they were probably blacked out. They couldn't watch us on TV tonight. That's why they're here, right?
1-0 the count.
Look at that. That's great to see.
Corners in close. Pitch low, 2-0. Yankees still leading Minnesota 2-1. That game now in the top of the 8th inning at Minneapolis. There's the strike. So if Toronto would lose and the Yankees would win, the Yankees just 2.5 back.
Amazing.
He started to come up with the right arm and did not. And it's 3 balls and a strike.
Are we looking at what Pete Rozelle did for the NFL? Looking at parity around the Major League Baseball these days?
I don't think so. Full count to Johnson. Outfield way around to the left. In fact, Gonzalez almost guarding the line, picking up on some of the Sox defensive positioning. Probably the most radical of anybody in all of the major leagues. But it sure works. He's gone. 1-2-3 inning for Nolan Ryan. 5th strikeout, and after 3.5, no score. A reminder, this copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Chicago White Sox and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form without the expressed written consent of the Chicago White Sox. And as we have seen, with the exception of one game, through the first 7 on this road trip, another good pitcher's duel. They won 14-7 game in Kansas City. Outside of that, Jack McDowell beat Cleveland 4-1. It's been 2-1, 3-2, 1-0, 2-0. As Pettis takes a strike from Alex. Pettis fly to left field his first trip.
Well, one game the Sox lost on this trip is 2-1 at Cleveland.
Yep. Well, it was a big trip for him. They knew it. As he pulls the string on him. And the count 0-2. Talking about resiliency. The Sox are a very resilient club. The youngest team in baseball for the 2nd consecutive year. They will just, we were talking about it today at lunch. This club will absolutely battle your behind. He's gone. He'll grab some bench gas.
There's a mismatch right there. Gary Pettis cannot hit a good high fastball, but he will chase it. It's one of his problems that he's had his entire career is that A, he doesn't lay off the high fastball, and B, when he does swing, he never gets on top of it. You see, he's underneath that one and a bit late.
So five strikeouts for Alex as Nolan Ryan has five. But there, this club right here will battle your behind. They're not afraid, I tell you, they're not afraid of anybody.
No. That's why they have all the problems with Oakland. Oakland knows that they won't roll over like some of the other teams.
You know, we've talked about that too. Those Oakland hitters hang out over the plate. Our guys aren't going to let them cover the outside corner. So if you're going to pitch inside every now and then, you're going to hit somebody. Palmeiro fouls it back. Rafael hit into a 6-4-3 double play. One of two turned thus far by the Sox. You know, that's one of the things we were talking the other day, and a couple of writers asked me about that Oakland situation, and I still don't think a lot of people got that thing figured out yet. Tries to backdoor and misses, and the count 2-1 with Tony, because every time one of their hitters gets hit, Tony goes out there, starts getting on the umpires, then his pitcher will throw at somebody. What he wants to do is get the umpire to put the warning on. That way his hitters, now at that point, they know nobody's going to come inside. You pitch those Oakland hitters down the way, and they're going to kill you.
That's right. It's like giving them a license to steal.
That's exactly right. And that's why Tony goes out there with those histrionics and those theatrics. There's a shot. That's down into the corner, but Sammy's tries to get there. He's going to not take it cleanly, so a double for Palmeiro. It's the 17th double for Rafa.
Oh, boy, I'll tell you, it's a great job of being able to keep that ball fair, Hawk. He's got that open stance up on the plate. He's a little bit of an inside-out swing to hit this pitch right on the inside corner, and he nails it. Gets the head of the bat out, but is still able to pull his arm to right there and keep that ball fair. Had a great head right on the ball. You can see the contact point. He's one of the truly pure hitters in the game. He really uses his hands great.
So one out, Palmeiro at second, and here's Ruben Sierra. He just missed one deep into right center field his first trip. Outfield swings around in unison to the right. Pascal well back at first. Fastball right there. Well, I love to watch this guy hit.
Yeah. That's amazing. Sometimes he'll go up there, and obviously he's going to take the first pitch, so he'll let something go right down the middle of the plate, as he did right there. You'd think, well, why wouldn't he swing at it? And the next pitch, this pitch could be a foot out of the zone, and he'll go after it. If they're smart, that's what they'll do. Well, this one is a bit too far outside.
A ball of striking out. Julio Franco on deck. That's hard hit right at Sammy. Boy, he hammered that curveball from Alex. Right now, with two out, let's check some scores around both leagues for you. There you see the game now in the ninth inning, Toronto with Cleveland. Tied at one. Kansas City shutting out Baltimore 7-0. Minnesota. It's the Yankees leading Minnesota 3-1. Yankees leading Minnesota 3-1. There you see the other schedule of games in the American League. The Yankee-Minnesota game now in the bottom of the eighth inning, with New York leading 3-1, trying to break Minnesota's nine-game winning streak. Here's Franco. There you see Giants over the Cubs 8-6-10. Cincinnati in the ninth inning now, leading Montreal 6-1. 1-0 Pittsburgh over the Dodgers, a rain delay. And the rest of the National League scores as Franco takes the ball. Julio a strikeout victim, his first trip.
You wouldn't have after that bad slider after he felt he got robbed on a couple of calls by umpire Ted Hendry. So he's ahead in the count right now, 1-0. Gonzalez on deck.
Pull a string on the curveball. He did not go, says John Hirschbeck at first. And the count 2-0. Now feel around to the right.
That's amazing how Franco hits in that hog. We didn't talk about a whole lot about him yesterday, but he uses about a 35, possibly a 36 ounce bat. And he has two fingers over the knob, as you can see, right there, to get even more extension. You got to be some kind of strong to do that. That left hand is barely on the bat. Just two fingers.
And in the words of Lee Trevino, in correlation to golf, Franco, for the most part, is a pull hitter. He hits everything to right field. Just like Trevino says when they say about that left to right, he said, to me, that's straight.
That's right.
So it's just semantics. They're going to go ahead and put Franco on to get to Gonzalez.
And the pitch to Gonzalez, he's got 38 RBIs and 38 ball games so far this year. But the Sox have had his number so far in this series. Didn't get anything last night, and he struck out his first time up.
So two out, two on.
I was talking to Toby Hero before the ball game, and he said that Gonzalez was trying to pull the ball too much. You know, he's really flying off the ball last night. He has tremendous power to right center field into the gaps, and that's where he's got to try and hit the ball.
See how this young battery, 21-year-old Fernandez, 24-year-old receiver Matt Marullo, want to go at him. Breaking ball away. Well, of course, those pitchers have a little something to do with how you approach what you're trying to do with them. They're going to change speeds, and they got four pitches and can get them over. I'm not afraid to throw the fastball inside. Then you got a problem on your hands. I don't care if you got awesome power everywhere. If they control the speed of that bat. Pull the string right there, misses. Now he's got a problem. Now Gonzalez, this is the best shape he's been in any of the at bats that he's had thus far in a two game series.
No doubt about it. 2-0, he's been hitting 0-2, 1-2 the entire time.
Plus he's got some ducks on the pond. Some guys have a better comfort zone for some reason with men on base. You know, we mentioned a guy named Rico Petrocelli, who still holds the American League record for home runs for a shortstop with 40. You put men on base and Rico, he was just devastating. Nobody on. Just, for the most part, an easy out.
Wow.
2-0. That's in the center field. Lance has room, plenty of it. Makes a catch, a good pitch. 2-0 fastball on the fist, and that'll retire the side. Nothing across the hit, no errors, two left. After four, no score. That's the story, top of the fifth inning. And a reminder, kids, you can be a part of the White Sox with a membership to the Silver and Black Pack for only $15. That membership includes six coupons for six designated games, an official membership card, free Cokes at White Castle, a certificate, a T-shirt, and fun stickers. So just pick up your Silver and Black Pack application at your nearest White Castle restaurant. That's a good deal. Also, a lot of White Sox fans in attendance tonight. A lot of them have come down from Chicago. From Chicago Heights, Joe and Arlene Brody. And Arlene's father, Joe Pavlin, who is 94 years young. Congratulations to Joe, old-time Sox fan. Since the days they played at 39th in Wentworth.
Well, Mike Tucker from Highland, Indiana is also here. Wants to say hello to everybody back home.
Here's Joy Cora. Takes a fastball strike. Joy, triple down into the right field corner, his first trip. No runs, three hits, no errors for both teams. Bouchel at the cut of the grass at third. Palmeiro in close at first. 1-1 the count. Tomorrow night, Charlie Huff against John Barfield. In a finale on Thursday, Greg Hibbert against Gerald Alexander. To Harper right side, Franco, one out right now. Let's pause for station identification.
This is WGN-TV Chicago, America's number one sports station.
Along with the Wimperoo Tom Petrick, this is the Hawk Ken Harrelson from Arlington Stadium. Jam-packed house tonight to see number 34 out on that hill. He has five strikeouts, the same as Alex, as Ozzie steps in. Ozzie popped up to his counterpart, Jeff Houston. Pops that one back out of play. Well, Wimpy, U.S. Open's getting ready to start up there at Hazeltine. Who's your pick to click up there?
Well, not being very...
I'll give you three and I'll take three.
Not knowing a thing about golf is what I'm trying to say.
Oh,
but you gave me Payne Stewart.
No, I said, I'll take Payne. You took him.
Yeah. Greg Norman. And who's the other guy you gave me? Wally Putz? Molly?
That's on the outside corner. No, I would take Payne, but you want him. I'll tell you what, I'm gonna go with three guys. I'm gonna go with the guy who won it last year. Hale Irwin.
Oh.
Lanny Watkins. And Scott Hoke.
All right, I was gonna take Sam Snead and Ben Hogan, but
Sam's on the DL. Here's the 0-2 pitch to Ozzie. That'll be out of play. Just getting a piece of it.
I looked at that golf course and on the newspaper one day. Those holes are about 9 miles long, each one.
It's a good golf course. Mike Schultz, the head pro there. Wonderful guy. In fact, we'll go, when we go up to Minnesota, we will go out and play it.
They wouldn't let me out there, would they?
Well, we'll have to carry some of that soil with us. There's a shot, base hit into center field. So Ozzie, one for two. He just battled him. Ryan, in disgust, just kicks the mound.
Well, Nolan doesn't like to give up hits on 0-2 pitches. And Ozzie's a good low ball hitter, and he went out and dug this one out. He dug this one out. Watch it right here. A fastball down. Pretty much middle of the plate. Watch the swing by Ozzie, head going down. Boy, he hung with him. And he gets a base hit. That's four for the Sox. They have good speed aboard. And their hottest hitter in Tim Raines at the plate.
Ozzie 9 for 12 in stolen bases. Timmy 1 for 2. He singled to lead it off. He also stole a base. As we mentioned, Ryan does not have a good move to first. Good lead by Ozzie. He takes off. There's a throw by Petrelli off to the other side. They still get him.
Boy, it sure didn't look like it. From the get-go, it looked like Ozzie had a real good jump. Throw was to the third base side. Well, that's close.
We'll see from this angle. Ozzie beat the play. Raines fouls it over into the Ranger dugout in the count 1-1. Just take another look right here from this angle where you can see it. You see Ozzie's foot get the bag as Houston's got to go get it and then bring it back over. Gets the bag
and then
the tag.
Yeah.
Indeed, he beat the play. Turns it over, misses, and the count 2-1.
You can't have calls like that against a pitcher like Nolan Ryan. You knew the Sox were going to run on him anytime a fast guy gets on base, because you just can't rely on getting three hits in an inning off a pitcher of the Ryan's caliber. And that was 3-1 to Timmy Raines, so he's in the driver's seat in this at bat.
You see what the opposition is hitting against Nolan Ryan. That's ball four. So we'll see some more action out there on the base paths. First walk issued by Ryan. So Ryan showing a little sign there. 0-2 base hit by Ozzie. Got a big break as they missed the call at second base on him, and he walks the one guy he doesn't want to walk.
Yeah, Timmy should be taking off any one of these first couple of pitches to try and get himself in scoring position.
Ventura one for two. He's popped a third and he doubled right over the, almost over the bag, down the right field line. There goes Timmy. Petrelli comes up, not in time. A stolen base, number 20 for Reigns.
He got this one easy. Another great jump by Timmy. He knows Nolan Ryan's move to the plate. And Petrelli with the high throw, no chance to get Timmy. So he is 20 for 24 in stolen bases this season.
There's a shot. Franco makes the play. Mercy. A bullet by Ventura, and that'll do it. Nothing across the hit, no errors, one left. And after four and a half, no score. A participating advertiser of White Sox baseball is Kohler Dodge, where it's Advantage Dodge. Kohler Dodge out in Naperville. But right here, it's the bottom of the fifth inning. Lower third of the order, Petrelli, Bushell, and Houston to face Alex Fernandez, who thus far has been equal to the task tonight. Alex giving up three hits. Ryan's giving up four. Ryan has five strikeouts. Alex has five strikeouts. So here's Petrelli. He was called out on a 3-2 fastball right down the middle his first trip. Outfield swung around to the right. Fastball high off the plate. Minnesota picked up a run. They now trail, still hitting in the bottom of the eighth inning at Minneapolis. They trail the Yankees 3-2. Top of the 10th at Cleveland. Blue Jays and Tribe locked up at one. That pitch out of play. Atlanta hitting in the top of the ninth inning, trailing the Mets 2-1. Philadelphia at Houston, no score, bottom of the seventh. Cincinnati beat Montreal 6-1 at Olympic Stadium. Blues a happy camper.
Yeah. Well, they'll get that big red machine cranked up.
I think they will, yep.
Yeah. They got too good a ball club.
Two balls, two strikes to the 31-year-old Ranger catcher, Gino Petrelli. Charlie Huff, starting tomorrow night's game, said the first thing he's going to do is drill Gino.
That was his personal catcher while he was here. Look out.
Full count. Minnesota still hitting, bottom of the eighth inning, now lead the Yankees 4-3.
Oh boy, jeez, when you're hot, you're hot.
It's hard into center field, Lance.
Third baseman, Steve Bouchel.
Charlie's 0 for 7 in this series. And he's hit five line drives.
Yeah. That ball was hit very hard. That was a good pitch by Alex. It came down and in, and Gino guarding had that little inside-out swing right there. Hit it hard, right on the barrel of the bat.
Here's Steve Bouchel. Steve hit a high chopper right over, just over the head of Alex into center field for a base hit. Outfield swung around to the right there, bunched. Ventura way back at third. Robin, foul ball. Bouchel, a free agent after this season. One of the things about him is he saves so many runs. And when you got a mediocre pitching staff, That's how you dress them up a little bit, is with great defense.
Yeah, that's true. Ooh, good pitch by Alex. Would have jammed him severely. Yeah, and especially if you don't have a whole lot of hard throwers, lefties or righties, and right-handed hitters are going to be hitting a lot of shots towards that third baseman or in the area. So if you have somebody with great hands and good athletic ability, great athletic ability, as a matter of fact, with Bouchel's case, you know, he certainly is a fine player to have.
He's the kind of player that, as that's in the hole, Ozzie can't get there. So Bouchel's got a couple of seeing eye singles.
Well, that he has. And as you mentioned, Hawk, he's off to the best start of his major league career from a hitting standpoint.
Well, he carries some positive luggage with him as well. Good team player. Here's another one just outside the reach of Ozzie. Going hard to his right.
He gets a lot of topspin on those ground balls, as you can. He's kind of a wristy type hitter. And when he makes solid contact like he did right there, the ball has a tendency to get a lot of topspin and gets through the hole much quicker. When he drops his hands, though, he's almost an out man. He's been keeping him up pretty good so far this season.
I was just getting ready to say that he's the kind of guy, though, that you'd like to have on a strong contending team. He's good for that because of his defense and his attitude. Here's Houston. He drew a walk his first trip. Takes it low. That's five in a row to Houston.
Sometimes that happens. Jeff hitting just 194 as he stands in there.
Boy, look at this Ranger. Averages down incoming at 317. Palmeiro 313. Sierra 330. Franco 307. Gonzalez 314.
Yeah.
And you walk in Houston.
Yeah, you can't do that.
One oh delivery. Reigns got to hurry. He's there. Yes. And makes the catch.
Boy, Timmy,
two gone.
Whew. He covers some ground right there. That ball was hit hard by Houston. But that Sox nickel defense, they knew what the tendencies are for those hitters to do. And a fine play by Timmy. Oh, a great speed out there right now with, there's a fastball, pretty much middle of the plate, a little bit late on that is Jeff Houston. But look at Tim Raines off to the races. It's going to be tough to hit a ball in any of the gaps when you got speed like Raines, Johnson, and Sosa out there. You got to hit in the seats, keep it away from those guys.
So that'll bring up Brian Downing. Downing a single and he struck out. Man checking the Sox minor league report last night at Vancouver. Our buddy Wayne Edwards did another good job. He had won his, he had a record of 2-0. He got beat last night 1-0. He worked seven innings, giving up only four hits and one run, and the guy threw a no-hitter against him.
It's kind of luck Wayne Edwards has been having.
Oh, Wayne will be back. Jeez. He'll be back.
He's a fine man. Isn't
he is. He deserves to be in the big leagues, too.
Yeah.
Curveball lays off him.
I bet he had a couple of great lines after that game.
Birmingham lost last night. That was the second straight night they've lost. That's the first time in a month. Jeez. They've lost two in a row. Birmingham with a record of 38-20 in first place in the Southern League. That's low. Two balls and a strike. South Bend was rained out in Beloit. They'll play a doubleheader tonight. John Jenkins and Kevin Toler will tee it up. But right here, Alex, with a 2-1 count to Downing, two out. Bouchel short lead at first. Took just a little something off that breaking pitch, and Downing with a big rip.
Brian obviously looking for something hard, but these young White Sox pitchers aren't giving in to the Texas hitters. They count even at two, and he can expect anything right now.
Minnesota still hitting in the bottom of the eighth inning. They might be putting some more. They lead New York 4-3.
Boy, they got the Mo on their side, don't they?
Good stop by Matthew.
But Downing almost went after that one. They're going to appeal, and Hirschberg says no.
Well, last time he had him 3-2. two men on. Threw him a slider way down out of the strike zone. He went after it, and they turned a double play by throwing out Bushell at third.
And you can see Brian is not on Alex Fernandez.
So this time we'll see what he wants to do with him, 3-2.
Oh boy.
He walks in. So the third walk issued by Alex, one of them intentional. And that'll bring up Gary Pettis. Toronto did not score in the top of the 10th at Cleveland. The game tied at one as now pitching coach Sammy Ellis out to the mound. Gary Pettis is not a good fastball hitter when you get it up.
Right.
So you don't want to give him a chance to hurt you on anything off speed down. And pretty sure that's what Sammy wants to make clear to Alex.
Yeah, you don't want to give up any runs, especially when Nolan Ryan is pitching against you. And of course, Sox are playing him to swing late at that high fastball. And if they throw him anything that he has a possibility of pulling, a couple of runs could score because they're shifting way around to the left.
Rain's guarding the left field line.
Yep.
Fastball.
Just climb the ladder on him is the way to approach Gary Pettis, especially in this at bat where you need the out. Look at these guys. That's that nickel package we talk about.
Pettis, 33-year-old veteran, two oldest guys in his lineup at the top of the order. Downing at 40, Pettis at 33. Ooh. Pull the string on him right there. And a count 0-2.
Good curveball, but not the proper pitch to Pettis. If he hooks that ball in the corner, you got big trouble.
Minnesota has added another one, still hitting, bottom of the eighth. Lead New York 5-3. So Alex way on top, 0-2. Matt to the inside. Well, if you're going to play a guy that extreme, you got to pitch him that way.
Yeah.
Pitching fastballs up out over the plate. Occasionally, if you want to, come in up and in on with one.
Yeah. As a hitter, you got to realize that too. Almost sending you a telegram of what they're gonna, how they're gonna pitch you.
Curveball, going inside, and the count 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two out, no score, bottom of the fifth inning. Totals on the board identical, 0-4-0. There's Bushell and Downing. Fastball, watch out. Fired over into the Sox dugout. Warren Newsom. Next to Thomas, Greg Graback, Wakamatsu, and Dr. DeBakey, Herm Schneider. As Pettis has to go back and get a new one, there's Matt. Alex having a chance to have a little conference. Fastball, Matthew.
Yes.
Alex, fastball. You don't want to get to that number 25 on deck. You don't want to screw around with this guy.
No. And this is a big pitch right here at 2-2.
So Alex still has some edge.
No.
Tried to pull a string on him, missed way upstairs. And now that fastball of Alex shortens up by about 6 inches.
Yep.
On a 3-2 count.
And both runners will be in motion naturally. 3-2, two out.
Fastball. Chops it foul down by Toby Harrah. So Downing and Bushell return to their respective bases. Cleveland did not score in the bottom of the 10th. In that 1-1 tie with the Blue Jays. Again, the payoff pitch. Fastball hit right at Tim Raines. He's there. He'll grab some bench. Nothing across the threat here. Two left. After five, zip, zip. No score, top of the sixth inning. Sox fans, as we mentioned, Wimpia took Casey over to Six Flags today, and I'll tell you, the two hats that I saw the most of were the Sox and Oakland.
Isn't that something?
I mean, the Sox, there were Sox caps all over the place.
Every city we go to, nothing but White Sox hats and shirts, the whole nine yards.
Here's Big Frank, takes it up high. He was hit by a pitch. He was drilled by a Ryan fastball in the first inning. Popped a second and a third. There's a strike on the outer half. And a reminder that Thursday, June 20th at 7:05, the Sox host the Kansas City Royals. And it will be Kodak camera night. Fans will be able to come onto the field and photograph their favorite White Sox players. Tickets are still available. Just dial 312-831-1SOX. Can't get that one, Big Frank. You got to make him get the ball down. That high heat, tough to get up on top of in the count 1-2. That's out of play right side. Well, in the last 24 innings that Nolan Ryan, in his last three starts against the Sox here at Arlington Stadium, he has given up no runs, two walks, has 36 strikeouts and eight hits.
That's real good.
That curveball almost locked him up.
Oh,
started to buckle him. Big Frank tried to stay with it. And the count 2-2.
It locked me. I'm a couple hundred feet from the plate.
That's a jelly leg curveball there.
Oh, man.
Petrelli to the outside. Fastball. So the first out, and that'll bring up Dan Pasqua.
We're bringing in the heat right here. See the good fastball? Bang. Outside corner just above the knee. Strikeout number six, and here's Danny.
Ryan probably has made better pitches on Pasqua tonight than any other hitter in his lineup. Shot on the fastball. Watch out.
Goodness.
Boy, a rocket. Back in the third inning, Ryan backdoored him with a curveball. Nolan Ryan backdoors you with a curveball if you're a left-handed hitter. That's not fair.
No.
Outfield straight up. 1-1 to count. Got a lot of rain delays on the East Coast. Got a rain delay in New York. They postponed the Dodger game. But there's not a rain delay at the Astrodome.
No.
Or at the Metrodome. A pie 2-1. First time Danny was up there, he had passed with, or he had Ryan 2-1, and Ryan threw him a good straight change, and he changed on him on 3-2. So you can see, he definitely has made some tough pitches on Pasqua. It's on the outside corner. Matt Marullo on deck. Full count. And now that 3-2 change, first time up, comes into play in the mind of Pasqua. And just that little thought adds just a little more on the fastball if he decides to come with it.
He made a change between innings. Mike Stanley is now catching. Oh boy.
Got him on the outside corner. Jeez.
That's a hat trick for Danny tonight, but I'll tell you, here it is on the corner. Look at it. Fastball bang right there at the knees. Couldn't pull the trigger once again, so Marullo will hit with two out.
There's Stanley. Matt's 0 for 2 tonight. Twice he's gone out to Sierra. First time he just missed it. Matt, really, he and Robin appear to be the two hitters in the lineup, along with Raines maybe, but they're comfortable. That's high in the right field. Just a little quick on it. He just misses this one as Sierra will make the play, and it'll retire the side. 1-2-3 inning for Ryan. Second time he's done it in the game, and after 5.5, another good pitcher's battle, no score. There it is, bottom of the sixth inning. Alex Fernandez taking his warm-up tosses, and as he does, a reminder, Friday, June 21st at 7.05 p.m., the Sox play host to the Texas Rangers. Be one of the first 20,000 fans to arrive in the park and receive a diamond sock pin courtesy of Scott Peterson. Tickets are still available, so just call or visit your nearest Ticketmaster outlet, 312-831-1SOX. It'll be the heart of the Ranger order. Palmeiro, Sierra, Franco. And if one of them gets aboard, Gonzalez. Pack house here at Arlington Stadium tonight as the Rangers trying to break an 8-game losing streak and the Sox trying to make it 6 in a row on their winning streak. Palmeiro 1-for-2 takes a fastball outside. Outfield swung around to the right. To another count. Saw a former Ranger reliever, Cleveland.
Oh, no.
Jim Curran. I saw him at lunch this afternoon. I asked him what he was doing. He's got a hunting, fishing, and photographic consultant business here called Emu Outfitting.
Outfitting. Emu, the largest non-flying bird. Isn't that right?
That's right.
That's his nickname.
Jim looks good.
What, did he have a heater or what?
Yeah, he could get it up there in a hurry.
Yeah. Tell you, the most afraid I ever was on a baseball field was when he was pitching for the Rangers. I was in the on-deck circle for the Mariners, and he hit the hitter, Casey Parsons, right in the neck. What about, there's a foul back. What about a 98-mile-an-hour fastball? And that was a scary moment. It was tough getting up in that batter. Casey was okay, by the way, but it was, you know, it was kind of weak-kneed going up there following that at bat.
What's a swing right here? One of the prettiest swings in baseball.
Yep, he just didn't quite get on top of that fastball.
Boy, he is some kind of hitter.
Yeah.
Yeah, Kern. He can throw.
Oops.
Pulls a string, get him out in front, but meanwhile, miss low and inside, and the count goes full.
Emu Outfitting. So if you want to look like an emu anytime.
He might be the only guy around here that can find some emus in Texas.
That's right.
Walks the leadoff man. And we get a final as the Twins continue with their winning streak, make it 10 now. They come back to beat the Yankees 5-3. Bottom of the 11th inning at Cleveland. Blue Jays and Tribe still tied at 1. Ruben Sierra He just missed one in the second inning, and he lined hard to Sosa in the fourth. That's into left center field. Reigns. Timmy's there. One gone.
I tell you, that's about the fifth ball in two nights of Ruben Sierra. Has just missed nailing. He's got outstanding power out that way. But he's just not quite getting to the ball the way he'd like to, just missing it. Take a look. Fastball. Didn't quite get it out in front. You can see just missing. Well, I'll tell you what, he's got a pretty swing too. And there's Timmy Raines flagging it down. So there's one out for Julio Franco.
He struck out and he was intentionally walked back in the fourth inning. Sox have turned two double plays tonight. Nice block by Marullo. And a count 1-0.
It's a super play by Matt to prevent that potential big run to get in scoring position. As you can see, boy, he just sacrificed his body to get out there. And Palmeiro stays put. Still can't believe it. I've never seen anybody with two fingers over the knob.
That's in the right center field. Lance. Now Sammy calls him off, makes the catch, two gone. No, I don't recall seeing two fingers. I've seen a lot of guys obviously with one over the knob, but I don't think I've ever seen anybody with two.
He's the only guy I've ever seen.
So with two out, that'll bring up Juan Gonzalez. He has struck out and he's flying to center. Final now from Shea Stadium. After that rain delay, Mets beat the Braves 2-1. Cincinnati beat Montreal 6-1 up in Canada. Giants beat the Cubs 8-6 at Wrigley Field. And bottom of the ninth at Houston, Phillies and Astros, no score. There's a base hit on the breaking pitch in the left field. The Reigns gets to it. Palmeiro holds it second. Gonzalez picks up his first hit of the series. He is now 1-for-8.
Well, he just caught this one off the end of the bat. Didn't really mash this ball.
He'll take it.
Oh, you're not kidding, especially when you're scuffling up there. His average has dipped quite a bit.
So here's Mike Stanley making his first plate appearance tonight. You see the numbers on Mike. 234, two homers, nine RBIs. And we still have not heard a report on why Gino Petralli left the ball game. Way swinging the bat, even though he is hitless, as we mentioned, Petralli was 0-for-7 in this series with five line shots. So evidently something definitely is wrong with it.
Yeah. And Jeff out to confer with that young battery of his, Matt Marullo and Alex Fernandez. He realized every pitch that Alex makes from here on out has got to be big and it's got to be thought over well. You got Mike Stanley. They're probably just going over that scouting report that they have on Mike, seeing that's his first at bat in the series. He'll probably be catching in the game against Hibbert, but they had not anticipated certainly this move.
So here we go with two men aboard. Palmeiro at second, Gonzalez at first, two out. No score, sixth inning. And after all the conversation, a fastball right there. You know, I used to hate it, I swear. I hated it when somebody would come out when I came to the plate and go out there and talk. Because I would just sit there and try to think in my mind what. I said, well, they're going to try to throw me the slider low and away, a curveball low and away, and all of a sudden, boom, first pitch fastball right there, and I'm looking for that slider. So, yeah, I don't know why I'm looking for it, because I can't do anything with it if I get it anyway.
That's right. The one pitch you're going to hit in that at-bat, you have a chance of getting a hit on, you take.
Another fastball, they come right at him, and the count quickly 0-2.
Well, Mike Stanley was supposed to be the savior for this organization a few years ago. Hasn't really worked that out that way for Mike. As a catcher at Oklahoma City, he was just starring. I think it was either 86 or 87. Was called up to the club and had an excellent first half of his career. But since then, he really hasn't done much from an offensive or a defensive standpoint. So he's just hanging on, really trying to make the team in spring training the last couple of years.
Yeah, Mike, 27 years old. He was not on the roster when they took him down there, 6 feet, 190 pounds. And you're right, Wampy. When he first came in, it looked like he was going to be a good offensive player. He looks like he's supposed to hit. He's got a good swing.
Right.
Of course, you know, you never can get inside a guy's head or his stomach, and see so many guys who, well, it's other times too, it just takes some guys a little longer than others. But he was a good-looking player. Good-looking hitter, I should say.
Yeah, kind of a Steve Garvey-ish type of swing up there. Hit the ball with great power the opposite field. The Sox are playing him that way to hit the other way.
Alex still up in the count of 1-2 as Matt moves to the inside. Watch out.
Wow. They want it up and in. You got it up and in.
That ball really was not that far inside. As you saw, even on the 0-2 count there, Stanley starting to dive out over the plate. Double him up in there one time, Alex. This time for a strike. In on the fist. Explode that bat. Nope, breaking ball. Hit in center field for a base hit. Here comes Palmeiro's. Lance gets to it. Here's a throw. They try to cut it off, not in time, and the Rangers lead it 1-0.
Well, Mike Stanley has always been a better breaking ball hitter than fastball. And right there is a pretty good reason why. He shows you breaking ball out over the plate. Let's see the location. Actually, it's an excellent location. And say if you want to diagram a pitch, this is where you want it to be. It was kind of a rolling breaking ball, you see it. It wasn't a real sharp breaking curveball. And he hammers it up the middle. Lance, it looked like he had a shot at Palmeiro. Danny tries to cut it off. The throw was off the line on the third base side. So the Rangers in business here in the sixth inning with their first run.
Well, all started with that leadoff walk to Palmeiro. There's Buscelli's 2-for-2. Activity down in the Sox pen is southpaw Ken Patterson. Starts to loosen up. Yeah, you get on the guy 0-2 and throw him a fastball way high and inside like that. He come back in there with a strike on the inside corner with another good heater. If he does anything at all with it, it's going to be foul.
Yeah. Especially when you're in command of the count.
You see him 0-2 diving out over the plate. There's Patterson. Yeah, in the bullpen, you throw it on the sideline, that 1-2 breaking pitch right there. You say, yeah, that's the way to do it. Meanwhile, base hit RBI, you're trailing 1-0. Ball stopped nicely by Marullo. Third time he's done that tonight. And the count 2-0. Run on 6 hits, no errors for Texas, no runs, 4 hits, and no errors for the Sox. Stanley, a very short lead at first. As Alex falls behind 3-0. Jeff Houston on deck. I would imagine Buschel. You better be careful. He's probably going to be hacking right here.
I don't think there's any doubt about it. Oh, boy.
No doubt about it. Takes one right there.
No doubt he was taken.
Yeah,
man.
3-1 to count with two out. Another short lead by Stanley. That'll load him up for Houston. Leadoff walk to Palmeiro here in the sixth. Sierra fly to left. You get the two tough guys. Franco fly to right. Gonzalez with a little soft line drive, base hit in the left field. 1-2 breaking ball with Stanley. He beats up the middle. Line shot, base hit. Houston has walked and he's lined hard to Raines and left. And here comes Jeff Torborg. He's going to go get Patterson. The walks have been Alex Bain all season long. Alex coming in with 38 walks and 64 innings. He has walked five tonight. So a break in the action. As Alex will depart, Patterson will come on, and we'll be back to give you Ken's numbers right after this.
Alex Fernandez leaves with two out in the sixth inning, but the bases are loaded. Left-handed hitter Jeff Houston is scheduled to hit. Looks like Mario Diaz is on the on-deck circle, so Bobby Valentine is gambling right here, because Houston has been a defensive standout so far in this series. But bringing in the right-hander to face the left-handed throwing Ken Patterson. Numbers on KP. He's 1-0 with a 4.67 earned run average in 14 ball games, all in relief. He's given up 16 hits, 17 in the third innings worked. He's given up 10 walks and 10 strikeouts. So Ken Patterson with the good fastball, hard breaking ball, basically a two pitch pitcher coming on here in long relief, hoping to hold the Rangers right there, because you can't afford to get too far behind when Nolan Ryan is on the hill and he is the opposition. So Ken Patterson from Waco comes out to work.
Mario Diaz will hit for Houston. So one run in, Gonzalez at third, Stanley at second, and Bouchel at first. Run on six hits for Texas, no runs on four hits for the Sox. Outfield shading Diaz to the right, gap between Raines and Johnson. Ventura back at third. Diaz, 29 years old, out of Puerto Rico. Three balls, no strikes. Sacks full of Texans. No activity down in Sox pen as third walk of the inning. Leadoff walk to Palmeiro. Downing is one for two, a single, a strikeout, and a base on balls. That curveball inside, five in a row thrown by Patterson. There's a strike and a count, two and one. Stanley at third, Bouchelle at second, Diaz at first. Two balls, two strikes. Outfield bunching straight up for Downing. There you see the Sox defense. And a big pitch. Downing a good hack. He likes the fastball up just underneath him. Downing just missed it. That'll retire the side. But the Rangers get on the board. Two runs, two hits, no errors. There were three walks in this inning. Three men left. And after six, Nolan Ryan has a two-run lead. Top of the seventh inning. Two runs, six hits, no errors for the Rangers. No runs, four hits, and no errors for the Sox. There's Mario Diaz. He remains in the game for Houston at short. So here's Sammy. Sammy 0 for 2 tonight, struck out, bounced to third. Sosa still looking for his first hit in this series. 0 for 7. Outfield straight away. Jam-packed house tonight here in Arlington. That ball hit hard, going foul down the left field line. So just a long strike and a count, nothing in one.
That's the one pitch that Sammy Sosa can handle right now, is the pitch up and in, because he is flying out of there way too early before Nolan Ryan's even thinking about releasing the ball. So he's already there to hit that pitch. Now the pitch down and away is another story. Sammy's having a tough time getting to it.
That fastball foul back, and quickly it's 0-2. Taking some American League scores. Detroit at Oakland, no score. Top of the second inning. Milwaukee put one on the board in the top of the first. California hitting in the bottom of the first. Minnesota beat New York 5-3 at Minneapolis. Twins now with a 10-game winning streak. Eighth strikeout for Ryan. Cleveland hitting in the bottom of the 12th, tied at one. with the Blue Jays. Boston scored three in the top of the first at Seattle. And a rain delay at Baltimore, where the Royals are shutting out the Orioles 7-0, bottom of the seventh inning. Here's Lance, he's 0-2. Corners in close. There's a shot, base hit right by Rafael Palmeiro. Activity as you look at the southpaw, Kenny Rogers down in the Ranger pen. So good speed aboard in Lance. He's 9-for-12 in stolen bases. Sox have two tonight, both by Tim Raines, who now has 20 on the season.
Well, Lance really got the head of the bat out that right there. He has shown signs in the last few ball games of really coming out of that little funk that he was in. See the little line on Ryan. Just the one walk and eight strikeouts. He's now given up five White Sox hits. The fact that they're down two runs should not deter Lance if he gets a good jump here.
The pitch outside and the count 1-0. He was on point. Mentioned earlier in the National League, Dodgers at Pittsburgh rained out. Mets beat the Braves 2-1 at Shea Stadium after a rain delay. Cincinnati over Montreal 6-1 up in Canada. Easy toss by Ryan. They're underway at San Diego at Jack Murphy Stadium. Cardinals and the Padres, no score, bottom of the second. Into the bottom of the 10th inning down at Houston, Phillies and Astros, no score. And the Giants beat the Cubs 8-6 at Wrigley this afternoon. So Lance will come up on point in just a second. There he goes. He does not take off. That's Cora. High in the right field. Sierra two gone. Cora now 1-for-3. That'll bring up Ozzy. Ozzy has popped to short. Then hit a 0-2 fastball off Ryan Hart into center field for a base knock. Outfield swung around to the left. Gonzalez now going over more towards the line as Lance comes up on point. Does not go. Ozzie pops it up. Diaz now, Juan Gonzalez calls him off, makes a catch, and that'll retire the side. Nothing across the hit. No arrows, a man left after 6.5. 2-0 Texas.
Right now, let's check our light beer scoreboard. Cleveland beat Toronto 2-1 in 12 innings at Cleveland. Kansas City beaten up on Baltimore 7-0 at Memorial Stadium there in the eighth inning. And Minnesota came back and beat the Yankees 5-3 at the Metrodome. Just starting off in Detroit at Oakland. Boston leading Seattle 3-0 at the Kingdom there in the first inning. Milwaukee beating California 1-0 at the Big A in Anaheim. In the National League, it was San Francisco over the Cubs 8-6 in 10 innings. Cincinnati beat Montreal 6-1. Dodgers and Pirates postponed because of rain. And the Mets beat the Braves 2-1 at Shea. No score in the ninth inning, Philadelphia at Houston, and ditto in the second inning at San Diego with the Cardinals. And that's our scoreboard, and we are in the bottom of the seventh inning here at Arlington. Sox trailing the Rangers and Nolan Ryan 2-0.
Gary Pettis will lead it off. Pettis 0-for-3. Twice he has gone out to left field. He also has struck out. Ken Patterson in relief of Alex Fernandez. Lionel Fernandez was 5 2/3. Two runs earned, six hits, five walks, five strikeouts. $38,172 in attendance this evening. As Pettis has the count go to 2-0 on him.
I didn't know they had that many seats here. I thought it was right around 35.
That was the biggest crowd I've ever seen here.
Yeah.
Two balls, no strikes to the 33-year-old switch hitting center fielder. 2-1. Palmeiro on deck and Ruben Sierra in the hole. Corner's in close. Checks it up, fouls it off. So the count 2-2. And once again, tomorrow night, pitching matchups, Charlie Huff against the Southpaw Barfield. And in the finale of this four-game set, we will have it right here over WGN for you on Thursday. It'll be Greg Hibbert against Gerald Alexander. So the two guys who worked in relief last night for the Rangers, they will be the starters in the third and fourth game of the series. Fastball high and the count goes full. Seventh walk issued by Sox pitching tonight. And here comes Palmeiro. He started off that two-run six off Alex with a base on balls. He's 1-for-2 tonight, a double. Pettis, 10 stolen bases. Rangers have 40 as a team. Sox have 54. Squares the bunt. It's a good one. Robin's got a barehanded underneath. Yes, what a nice play by Robin Ventura on the sacrifice bunt by Rafael Palmeiro.
I'll tell you what, I don't think anybody was looking for a bunt right there. As good a hitter as Palmeiro is.
No, I wasn't.
I certainly wasn't anticipating. And it was a good one, too. Palmeiro looked like he stayed at home plate. Watch him. He wanted to make sure he got it down. He just kind of stayed there. And Robin has to go to his right and in to make the play. Makes the off-balance throw, and it's a perfect one. So another run is at second base, but with one out. And here's Sierra. He's going to turn around and bat right-handed.
Outstanding play by Robin Ventura. Sierra 0-for-3 tonight. And he is 0-for-8 in this series. Takes it up high. Outfield playing him the pull. Ventura well back at third. Curveball high and a count 2-0. Temperature here at Arlington at 10:08, 88 degrees. Beautiful day yesterday as you look at the temperature. A little warmer today. There goes a runner. There's the throw. Not in time. Nobody even giving Gary Pettis any kind of attention out there.
Well, Ozzy was playing Sierra in the hole, so it's very difficult for him to pay attention. Joey Cora's got to do a little bit better job of keeping him at second base. Of course, right now it doesn't matter because Pettis with the great jump right there. Marullo rushing throw, tougher to throw out a runner, certainly with the right-handed hitter up there.
Sox with the infield in and the count 2-2. Sierra, 8 homers, 38 ribbies. Pops it up. This will not get the job done as Ozzy makes the call. And the catch, 2 gone. But you're not out of a chance with the dangerous Julio Franco. He's 0-for-2. He struck out, was walked intentionally, and he's flying to right. Now outfield bunching. Franco straight up. Now Lance a couple steps over towards Tim in left field. And he's motioning Raines to move on over towards the line. So Patterson misses with a fastball up. Milwaukee has added another run as you look at the Sox defensive positioning. They now lead California 2-0, bottom of the second inning at the Big A in Anaheim. Two and oh the count. Patterson and Marullo taking a lot of time. Bottom of the third inning at the Coliseum. Tigers at Oakland, no score. Franco with a 3-0 count, Gonzalez on deck. They're just going to go ahead and put him on. So for the second time tonight, an intentional walk to Julio Franco to get two. Juan Gonzalez, he singled and scored. Last inning, he's 1-for-3. So the leadoff walk to Pettis. Sacrifice bunt by Palmeiro. Sierra pops up. Attention to walk to Franco. Good speed aboard with Franco. He has 10 stolen bases. Stole a couple last night.
And you got a hitter in Gonzalez against left-handers is hitting 350 this year. As opposed to 301 coming in against right-handed hitters, so he likes the lefties a little bit better, obviously. A big out for Ken Patterson to try and keep this game right where it is. Give those Sox hitters a chance to get loosened up for the last six outs of this game.
No activity in the Sox pen. As here's the 21-year-old left fielder. Takes it inside. Deep in the left field, Raines has the bead, makes a catch, and it'll retire the side. So a couple of walks, and Patterson's able to pitch his way out of it. After seven, Rangers lead it 2-0. That's the story, top of the eighth inning, and a reminder, there are still individual game suites available. You can enjoy these luxury suites as the Sox take on the Rangers or the Mariners. So just call the Sox sales office at 312-924-1000. Nolan Ryan, five hit shutout through seven innings, one walk, eight strikeouts, and he'll face the top of the order. Raines, Ventura, and Thomas. Tim 1-for-2 tonight, a single, a strikeout, a walk, two stolen bases. Corners in close. As it catches the outside corner, I don't think Tim appreciated that call very much. Outfield bunch, but they're swung around just a bit to the left. Palmeiro backs up at first as Ryan's coming right at him, gets on top, 0-2. Nolan Ryan picked up his 300th victory last year at Milwaukee on July 31st. We mentioned earlier, seven no-hitters, won this season against the Blue Jays, 12 one-hitters, 19 two-hitters, 33 hitters, and five times he's lost a no-hitter in the ninth inning. Timmy takes it low in the count of ball and two strikes. Well, they got a Lulu going at Houston. No score, top of the 11th inning, Phillies and the Astros. Just getting a little piece of it. Hanging tough at 1-2. Toby Harrow.
Spell his
Dave
name.
Oliver.
Spell Toby's name backwards and forwards. It's still Harrow.
Palindrome. Curveball. Strikeout number 9.
Well, this is nasty right here. Nothing but fastballs and then this. Yellowhammer right there down and in. Timmy couldn't catch up with it. Swinging right over the top. So Nolan Ryan now, 9 strikeouts.
Robin 1-for-3. Two hopper. He's 1-for-4. So with two out, here's the DH, Frank Thomas. Big Frank has struck out, popped up, and he was drilled. Ryan got him with a good fastball in the first inning. Thomas 0-for-3 last night, but had 2 walks. Looked at that curveball, and it missed. Stanley to the outside, fastball right there, and the count evens at 1. Ball on the outside corner, so it's 1-2. Jeff Russell has been loosening up down in the Ranger pen. He is ready in case anything were to go a little awry here. Rangers with both their runs in the sixth inning. Sox stranded 2 in the first, 1 in the third, 1 in the fifth, and 1 in the seventh. Time it looked like they had anything of consequence going was in the first inning. Raines led it off with a single, stole second. That's number 10. 1-2-3 inning for Ryan. And after 7.5, that's it. Eighth inning. Nolan Ryan, a 5-hit shutout, 10 strikeouts, leads it 2-0. And a reminder that Milk Duds and Jolly Rancher candies offer kids a chance to become a celebrity bad boy or girl. And winners receive great prizes and the chance to go on the field at New Comiskey Park to meet White Sox players. So just look for details wherever Milk Duds and Jolly Rancher candies are sold. Mike Stanley leads it off. He is 1-for-1 and an RBI. Takes it up high from the southpaw Ken Patterson. It's 2-0. There's a strike. So Stanley with 2 balls and a strike. Bouchel on deck and Mario Diaz in the hole. High into short left field. Ozzie going back, giving chase. Raines coming on. Now Ozzie makes a count, the call, and nobody gets it. Hopefully they are all right.
It'll probably be scored a double. Boy, this ball had a lot of hang time. Tim Raines is over in left center field, though. Mike Stanley, not much of a pull hitter. Ozzie going out. That Texas win may have grabbed this one. As you see Ozzie trying to make the over-the-shoulder catch. Timmy coming in out of the corner of his eye, as you can see, calling off Ozzie and isn't able to make the diving catch. So Stanley at second with a double. He's 2 for 2 now. And Bouchel, the hitter, he probably will be sacrificing here, trying to get that runner in to third with less than two out.
There you see Bouchel is perfect on the evening with those two singles and that base on balls. Corners in close. Pass with the cut of the grass. Outfield spreads out. There's a curveball. He fakes a bunt and takes a strike. So we count nothing in one. Short lead at second. Now the outfield shifts around just a little bit more as once again he fakes a bunt, takes a fastball up high, and the count evens at one. Pops it up, and there's Matt Marullo to make the play. One gone.
Well, the Rangers haven't done a whole lot of execution in this series. They've already stranded 10 runners in this ball game, and right there, not a good bunt at all. You can see Bouchel doesn't get the head of the bat out in front of home plate like you like to see it. A weak pop up, Matt Marullo right there. So Diaz is going to have to drive in this run with a base hit.
He drove in a run his only at bat with a bases loaded walk. That was the first hitter that Ken Patterson faced. 2-0 Texas leads it. That's off the end of the bat in the left field. Here comes Raines, makes the catch, and now all he's got to do is just go to second base. They're going to double Mike Stanley off, and that'll do it. So leadoff double by Stanley. He gets doubled up, and after eight, Sox down to their last three. It'll be Pascoe, Marullo, and Sosa. They trail it 2-0. It's the ninth inning as Nolan Ryan has got the Sox shut out as they try to even the series up at a game apiece. Also, Ryan trying to break the Rangers' 8-game losing streak and snap the Sox 5-game winning streak. Sox on this 10-game road trip coming in, they have won 6 out of 7 and 5 in a row. But Nolan tonight, that 5-hitter, he's walked just one. That was Tim Raines back in the 5th inning. And he has punched out 10 as Jeff Torborg exhorts his troopers on right here, trying to get something going. Pascua, Marullo, and Sosa, the schedule hitters, as the right-hander Jeff Russell continues to heat up for the Rangers down in their pen.
And the Sox need a base runner to get that tying run to home plate. 210 times now Nolan Ryan has struck out 10 or more hitters in a ball game.
That's unbelievable.
Isn't that incredible?
It's unbelievable. Here's Danny. He's been sort of kept at bay tonight by Mr. Ryan as he hits this one into right field. One pitch, one out. Danny now 0 for 4 with a 3 strikeout. Well, no wonder he's got so many strikeouts.
Boy, it didn't take us long to figure that one out, huh? 326 career strikeouts versus the White Sox, most against any major league team that he has faced. And that encompasses 2 leagues.
Here's Matt. He's 0 for 3 all 3 times tonight. Ruben Sierra is taking care of him. Fastball on the outside corner. 38,172. Cheering their hero on.
Boy, you really got to get Ryan early. We said that in the first inning. If you don't capitalize on early inning opportunities, it's going to be tough to beat him.
Just off the plate. And a count 1-1. So we saw an excellent umpire game last night from Terry Cooney. We're seeing another one tonight from Ted Hendry.
Yeah, nobody's complaining.
No. One and two the count. Warren Newsom has come out on deck to hit for Sosa. He pops this one up left side. It's playable in foul territory. Bouchel is there, makes a catch. So the Sox down to their last out. And here comes Newsom. Sammy tonight. Sammy was 0 for 3. A couple of strikeouts and a bouncer to third. And once again, tomorrow evening, it'll be Charlie Huff against John Barfield. And the finale on Thursday of this four-game set with the Rangers. It'll be the Little Bulldog Greg Hibbert against Gerald Alexander. And we will have that game on Thursday for you right here with WGN. Fastball strike. Curveball, base hit by Warren Newsom. What a thrill for this youngster, the rookie coming up. And he hits the 0-2 curveball off Ryan into left field. Attaboy, Warren.
Oh, boy. You're right. This has got to be a thrill. It doesn't look like a bad one either. Actually, for Newsom, it was up. Normal guy, probably down by his knees. Warren doesn't have a whole lot of height to him, as you can see. And it was about thigh high, so he nailed it. Good job of hitting, so the Sox still have life for Lance Johnson. He singled his last time up.
Yeah, Lance 1 for 3. Get something going here. Going down to second base, Warren. That pitch foul out of play in the count, nothing and one. 2 runs, 7 hits, no errors for Texas, no runs, 6 hits, and no errors for the Sox. Nolan Ryan trying to pick up his 61st shutout of his career, which will tie him for 8th place with Tom Seaver. Jeez. Two behind Warren Sparn and Mordecai Brown. Changes up on him. Lance out in front. So he's got Johnson. No balls, 2 strikes. Chopper up the middle. Franco taking him right to the bag. Catches it. Steps on second. And the ball game is over. So the 44-year-old right-hander Nolan Ryan has just picked up his 61st shutout of his career. Final score, Rangers win it 2-0. We'll be back right after this.
About this time.
Totals on the board for the second of this four-game set tonight for the Texas Rangers. 2 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They stranded 10 runners. For the Sox, no runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 6. The winner, Nolan Ryan, now 4-4. Alex Fernandez takes a loss. He is now 2-6 in our Miller play of the game tonight. Well, there was really not a play that was outstanding except Nolan Ryan picking up for the 210th time in his career, 10 or more strikeouts. So Nolan walking 1, striking out 10, and Wimpy. It was a situation there that the Sox really, in essence, could still be playing in this ballgame if Warren Newsom, with Palmeiro playing way back there, if he'd have gone, they were not going to throw Lance Johnson out on that play.
Well, there's no doubt about that, Hawk. The high chopper over the middle, it led Franco right to the bag. Now, if Newsom's at second, there is absolutely no way they throw out Lance, and we got a ballgame here.
All right. Nolan shuts the Sox out 2-0. We'll be back to wrap it up right after this. John Barfield.
to Rise and Shine, Fun Seekers. Southwest.
White Sox Baseball on Channel 9. The White Sox were brought to you by Miller Genuine Draft, cold filtered for real draft taste. So get out of the old, get into the cold. Phillips 66 high quality super clean gasolines, keeping your car's fuel injectors and intake valves clean for smooth driving performance. True Value, got a tough job to do? You can do it with True Value Hardware Stores. Coca-Cola Classic, you can't beat the real thing. Southwest Airlines, offering everyday low fares and convenient flights to both Detroit Metro and Detroit City airports. And your local Toyota dealers. I love what you do for me, Toyota.
A reminder, our next White Sox telecast on Channel 9 will be Thursday when the Sox wrap up this four-game series against the Texas Rangers. Coverage begins with the Dugout Show at 7 right here on WGN. Once again, the final score, Rangers win it 2-0. So for my partner, Tom Pachorek, and our producer-director, Skip Ellison, this is Ken Harrelson. So long, everybody. You know, I